Good morning and welcome to today's Healing Minute from virtual Harry Edwards Healing Sanctuary. I'm Tracy, talking to you from Reading. Wherever you are, thank you for making the time to join us, whether you're watching us live or on catch-up, and an extra special warm welcome to any newbies that have joined us today. So the piece I'm going to read later is called Small Present, Huge Gift, a beautiful memory of a simple gift and life lesson on the best way to solve problems you may encounter in life. And with that theme in mind, what better music to listen to than A Gift Remembered by Bernard Cook from the album Remembering. But first of all, we're going to start with some relaxation. Ourselves all nicely prepared for the Healing Minute. I hope you're somewhere comfortable. If you wish, all wrapped up, feeling nice and warm and cozy and safe. So please shut your eyes if it's safe to do so. Park all thoughts to one side and clear your minds of any worries or concerns. Bring your awareness to the breath. Remember the air we breathe, we share. It unifies us and connects all life on earth. We cannot see it. It's invisible. But without it, there'd be no life. So breathe in this invisible life force, this healing energy. Fill your lungs and feel the life it gives you. And as you breathe out, release all your personal stresses. Then take another deep breath in and exhale, allowing it to flow through your body. Breathing down through your head. Relax your eyes, your jaw, your neck. Breathe down through your shoulders to your arms, then through to your hands, and out through your fingers. Now another deep breath, this time breathing all the way down through your body, all the way down through to your base, down your legs to your knees, down through to your feet, and out through your toes. Now visualize yourself in your special place or time, on this fine spring day. And wherever you're enjoying a few minutes in your little bit of paradise, we'll begin our attunement for the Healing Minute. So we give thanks we're gathered here today. We ask that this place be filled with love, light, friendship, and healing energies. Surround us in protection as we open our hearts and expand our consciousness to allow the flow of love and healing to come through us. As your crown chakra opens, you feel or imagine a column of pure white light filling your body, then feel the balance and harmony within your body as the earth energy rises up through the soles of your feet and your base chakra. You feel your connection to the universal source of pure unconditional love, balanced by the nurturing, protective love of Mother Earth. And Harry Edwards remembered. Wherever you may be, I am there for you. You are not lost to me, I shall still care for you. I am not someone whom you once have known, taken away to leave you all alone. Tell me of the pain or fear deep in your heart. just softly speak my name, we're not far apart. So that in dreams, when the long day is through, I may send healing once again to you. And inner peace. Think peaceful thoughts, manifest peace in your actions, speak peaceful words. Hear the silence between the sounds, live in peace, and you will attract peace to you. From peace comes harmony, from harmony comes balance. When in balance, you receive clarity. Clarity enables you to see. You may see further than you've ever seen before. When your path is clear, you can find your purpose. While fulfilling your purpose, you fulfill your spiritual destiny for this life. And the great invocation. From the point of light within the mind of God, let light stream forth into human minds. Let light descend on earth. From the point of love within the heart of God, let love stream forth into human hearts. May the coming one return to earth. From the centre where the will of God is known, let purpose guide all little human wills, the purpose which the masters know and serve. From the centre which we call the human race, let the plan of love and light work out, and may it seal the door where evil dwells. Let light and love and power restore the plan on earth. And now for the healing minute. So we ask now that all the people whose names we hold in the distant healing folder may receive healing for their highest good. We also request healing for their family, friends, and people for whom they've requested distant healing. May they all be placed in the healing light and receive that which they're allowed to receive for their highest good. And our thanks and blessings for your help here today and to all our friends in spirit. Thank you so much, everybody. There. Wow, that's lovely. So our notices for today. So there's the choir on Thursday. They're meeting at 1 o'clock in the chapel. So do pop along there if you'd like to join in. And then John Phillips will be back on Zoom on Thursday the 23rd at 2 o'clock with another of his lovely meditations. And we have two In Conversation with Healers coming up on Zoom. On Thursday the 23rd, Alison will be talking with the world-renowned animal healer, Elizabeth Whiter. And then the following Tuesday, on the 28th, Alison will be interviewing Anna Haywood, a minister with the White Eagle Lodge. So do check out Alison's In Conversations with Healers and pop them in the diary. And then on Sunday, the 26th, that's next Sunday, do join Doreen in the chapel at 2 o'clock at the sanctuary for our Sunday service. It'd be lovely to see everybody there. The details of all our activities in March are on both Facebook and our website, so do check them out. And that leaves us for today for the reading. So I'm going to take a reading from The Chicken Soup to Inspire a Woman's Soul. Here we are. It's called Small Present, Huge Gift by Jenna Cazell. So problems cannot be solved at the same level of awareness that created them. That was by Albert Einstein. She was what everyone in my family referred to as eccentric. But to me, Aunt Madeline was a bright star in an otherwise mundane sky. Aunt Mad, as we all called her, always appeared a bit dishevelled, her jet black hair moving in directions as surprising to me as the direction of her thoughts, values and shared perceptions. I can't recall that she ever wore a bit of makeup, and her colourful attire screamed of independent creativity. An artist as passionate about her work as she was about life itself. She taught me many important lessons, but none more enlightening than during the holidays in the 10th year of my impressionable childhood. The whole family had gathered for the holidays in New York, grandparents, aunts, uncles, and a gaggle of cousins. Each of the adults, in turn, would announce the holiday gifts with great fanfare and proudly pass them to the child whose name appeared on the package. Within minutes, there was a flurry of loud activity with all the children tearing into boxes and wrapping paper flying in all directions. The adults looked on to see who had outdone the others in this year's gift-giving competition. The room filled with toys and stuffed animals and kids peddling their new toy cars through a river of endless wrapping paper and ribbon. After the initial flurry, the excitement began to calm. The kids lost interest in all the newly acquired clutter. It was then that Aunt Mad quietly stood and walked over to each child and handed us a small, colourfully woven 3-inch tube that was made of a kind of flexible construction paper. There was no wrapping and no explanation. She smiled the way she did when she challenged us to find the incredible beauty in one of nature's sculptures, a rock laying in the woods, bathed in sunlight. We each immediately began to examine this seemingly odd gift. It only took about 3 minutes for every child to have both index fingers stuck securely in each end of the tube. Each time we would try to remove our fingers, the tube would hug more tightly and leave us captive in this wonderful mystery, which Aunt Mad called a Chinese finger puzzle. Since it was the end of a long, happy day and time to go home, my brother and sister and I were piled into the back of our car as we began our 3-hour journey back to Pennsylvania. Almost immediately, Mum said to Dad, "Did you see that ridiculous gift Madeline gave the children? It couldn't have cost more than 25 cents a piece, and not even gift wrapped." What my mother had failed to notice was how the three of us were sitting quietly in the back seat, all struggling to free our fingers from the only gift that had managed to capture, literally and figuratively, our rapt attention for more than a few minutes. When we arrived home, my brother and sister asked my parents to rescue them. This was accomplished with careful surgical removal of the Chinese finger puzzle using a pair of scissors. My request for assistance in calling Aunt Mad, as rotary phones are hard to dial without the use of index fingers. When I asked my aunt for the secret of how to solve this problem, she laughed and said, "It is best to solve this as you would any problem you may encounter in life. Stop trying so hard. Let go of the struggle and you will be released. Good luck and good night." And with that, she hung up. I sighed deeply, not exactly understanding what she meant. I tried hard to not try hard, but wasn't sure how to do that. I was so tired I went to bed with my clothes on and my fingers stuck safely in the magical prison and quickly fell sound asleep. In the morning, the finger puzzle was lying next to me in bed. After school the next day, I cautiously placed my fingers back in the finger puzzle. I realised that if I pulled, the tube would tighten. But if I relaxed and actually moved my fingers towards each other, the tube would loosen, enough to simply remove my fingers. That was many years ago, and many holidays and gifts passed. Yet I can honestly say that was the best gift anyone ever gave me. And while I no longer have the finger puzzle and only have memories of Aunt Mad to make me smile, I will always have the benefit of that simple gift and the wondrous hands-on life lesson it offered. Now at age 49, when I find myself struggling to find out of some life challenge, I take a deep breath and I relax into the problem. As Aunt Mad has advised, I let go of the struggle and I am released. More often than not, just like that little finger puzzle, I find the answer in the morning. And that was by Jenna Castle. There. These life lessons. Now for some music. I thought you'd all enjoy this one. It's Don't Worry, Be Happy by Bobby McFerrin. Let's just pull that up. Just turn it up a bit.
Song I wrote, you might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble, but when you worry you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now. So don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Now there, this song I wrote, I hope you learned it note for note like good little children. Don't worry, be happy. Listen to what I say. In your life, expect some trouble. When you worry, make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Be happy now. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, don't do it. Be happy. Put a smile on your face. Don't bring everybody down like this. Don't worry. It will soon pass, whatever it is. Don't worry, be happy.
Such an important thing.
I'm not worried.
Ah, beautiful. Do please remember, if you need a chat, if you're worrying about anything, just give us a ring. We'll help you out. Just listen and listen and listen. Do call us if you need us. And if you wish to have some healing, you can do it either contact healing, phone, Skype, WhatsApp, whatever. We're all here for you. Just contact us in a normal way, and those details are on our website or Facebook page. So bye for now. Do join us again on Wednesday when Gary will be taking the virtual healing minute again around the sanctuary. And in the words of Albert Einstein, as I said before, problems cannot be solved at the same level of awareness that created them. And as Aunt Mad advised, let go of the struggle and you are released. So take care, everybody. Bye for now and see you next week.
Be happy.